On behalf of Rohini College of Engineering and Technology, I welcome you all. I am Verslin Baby, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. I am handling the subject Physics for Electronics Engineering. The subject code is PH8253. Now I am going to explain about classical free electron theory, which is under the unit Electrical Properties of Materials. After completing this course, the students will be able to recall electron theory of solids and also classical free electron theory. First of all, what is meant by conducting materials? That is, the materials which allow current to pass through them are called conducting materials. In conducting materials, the resistivity is very low. Next one is electron theory of solids. We know that the valence electrons determines the electrical properties in the solid. The free electron theory of solids explains the structure and properties of solids through their electronic structure. This theory is applicable to all solids, both metals and non-metals. There are three types of electron theory. First one is classical free electron theory. Next is quantum free electron theory. Third one is zone theory or band theory of solids. Let me see about classical free electron theory. It is a macroscopic theory which was proposed by Drude and Lorentz in the year 1900. According to this theory, the free electrons are mainly responsible for electrical conduction in metals. This theory obeys laws of classical mechanics. Next theory is quantum free electron theory. It is a microscopic theory that was proposed by Sommerfeld in the year 1928. According to this theory, the electrons in the metals move in a constant potential. This theory obeys laws of quantum mechanics. Next theory is zone theory or band theory, which was proposed by Bloch in the year 1928. According to this theory, the free electrons move in a periodic potential. This theory explains electrical conductivity based on the energy bands. Next one is the postulates of classical free electron theory. Generally, a solid is made up of atoms with nucleus at the center, and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Second postulate is the free electrons are moving like a gas molecules in a gas container, so they obey kinetic theory of gases. Third one is, in the absence of electric field, free electrons collide with each other. This collision is elastic collision. In the presence of electric field, electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal of the battery with the drift velocity. Here, see this diagram. The electrons are directed towards the positive terminal of the battery. Here, this diagram shows the direction of flow of electrons, which is towards the positive terminal of the battery. Next one, some of the important definitions or some of the terms. First one is drift velocity. The average velocity acquired by the free electrons in a particular direction by the application of electric field is known as drift velocity. Next one is mean free path. That is, the average distance traveled by a free electrons between any two successive collisions in the presence of applied electric field is known as mean free path. Next one, collision time. The average time taken by a free electron between any two successive collisions is known as collision time. Next one, relaxation time. The average time taken by a free electrons to reach its equilibrium position from its disturbed position due to the application of external electric field is called relaxation time. This relaxation time is approximately equal to 10 power minus 14 second. Let me see about the merits of classical free electron theory. This theory is used to verify Ohm's law, that is V is equal to IR. The electrical and thermal conductivities of metals can be explained by this theory. It is also used to derive Wiedemann-Franz law, also used to explain the optical properties of the metals. These are the merits of classical free electron theory. Next, the demerits or drawbacks of classical free electron theory. It is a macroscopic theory. Also, this states that all free electrons will absorb energy, but quantum theory states that only few electrons will absorb energy. This theory cannot explain the Compton effect, photoelectric effect, paramagnetism, ferromagnetism, etc., etc. Theoretical and experimental values of specific heat and electronic specific heat are not matched. By classical theory, K by sigma T is a constant, but by quantum theory, it is not constant for all temperature. The Lorentz number by classical theory does not have good agreement with experimental value, and it is rectified by quantum theory. This is all about classical theory. Thank you.